Dearly beloved, on this feast of our father, Saint Maroun, we begin our celebration for our Golden Jubilee, the 50th anniversary of the founding of our Maronite Eparchy in Australia. This Jubilee marks an invitation to return to our roots, to the fountains of holiness, and to our Syriac Maronite Antiochian heritage. It's also a call to turn our gaze to the mountains of Kurush in Syria, to Maroun, the monk, the priest, and the hermit, to the monks of Beit Maroun on the Asi River, and to learn from them how to live an unshakable faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. In the 7th century, a historic event took place with the election of St. John Maroun, Father Superior of Beit Maroun, as a Patriarch of Antioch, and we witnessed the foundation of the Maronite Church. From that time, the church bells rang, the fragrance of incense spread, and the mountains echoed the prayers of the Maronite monks and hermits in the Kadisha Valley. From that holy land, the Maronites set out. They spread out across the world and were planted like grains of wheat in new countries and different societies. As they were good crops, they grew in many fields, spiritual, social, human, and economic, especially here in Australia from the middle of the 19th century when the Maronite started to arrive. 50 years ago, in 1973, the Maronites gathered around their first Maronite bishop in Australia at St. Maroun's Church in Redfern. They prayed together and celebrated the Divine Liturgy to mark the beginning of a new chapter in the life of the community in Australia. Today, we thank the Lord for all His graces and gifts and for everything that has been achieved, especially the establishment of parishes, churches, monasteries, and the opening of educational, health, media, social, and other institutions. Dear friends, this Jubilee is a significant milestone in our journey as Australian Maronites. On the one hand, we give testimony to our Syriac Antiochian spiritual heritage through the life of faith and the visits of the relics of saints, Maroun, Sherbil, Rafa, Namtalla, and Mary MacKillop to our parishes and institutions throughout this year. On the other hand, we are called to continue the journey of openness to the cultural, ethnic, and religious diversity that characterizes our Australian society. In fact, it is our responsibility to carry the mission of our Maronite Catholic Church not only to Australia, but also to New Zealand and to the countries of Oceania following the expansion of our Eparchy's borders in 2021. Finally, as we read in the book of Leviticus, it is a Jubilee. It shall be holy to you. Today I renew my call to everyone so that this year be a blessed step towards holiness for all of us. I would also like to invite you all to welcome the relics of the saints visiting our churches, parishes, and monasteries during this year. It is a privilege and a blessing that our Jubilee Year Mass will be celebrated by His Beatitude and Eminence, Mar Bshara Butros Cardinal Rai, on 24 September in Homebush. Please do save the date so that you can take part, and more details are going to be communicated to you in due course. Brothers and sisters, let us continue to pray with each other and for each other, so that our journey is a constant pursuit of holiness and a daily experience of openness and togetherness in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Wishing you all a blessed Jubilee year.